And then when you come back over, try and reach as far as you can. So reach with your body. Yeah, and stop there. Yeah, good. Good. See that range difference there? That's all your shoulders working now. Good. Other side.
Gavin McDonnell, super bantamweight champ. I followed my brother into it. He won a European title. And I just give it that one. I said, if he can do it, I can do it. Went down to the gym with him, Stephen Ball and Dave Ollie. Started hitting bags and whatnot, and sort of enjoyed it. I had a few months in the gym and just said, look, I want to do it. I did all my medicals. I had to have a trial weight boxing board, passed all them, and then I had my first fight. And then I think it was my fifth or sixth fight, I had like an area title. And then ever since then, it just got bigger and bigger and bigger. And then I always dreamed of being like a British champ at most, do you know what I mean? But obviously as you get older, you achieve them goals, do you know what I mean? You pick your flag up, you finish, and do you know what I mean? And you move it, and before you knew it, I genuinely believed I was going to be a world champion. And that's the goal now. I mean, we've had a crack at a world title, and I know I'm capable of winning a world title, and that's it, that's where we're at, do you know what I mean? Been there, done it, picked all titles up, just got to go grab a world title.
Okay, a little bit deeper, deeper. There we go, drive it up fast. Gavin McDonnell's been training with us around about 6 months now, and he's only had like one six-rounder that ended up in a first-round KO victory. But this is a really big fight for him coming up against Gamal Yafai on the undercard of Kell Brook. And it was a really hard year last year for Gavin because he lost his world title fight, a very good effort. But since then, the opportunities have been a bit dry, so you can see it now that he's really appreciating them big opportunity fights because he's had two six-rounders, very low on the undercards. Now he's going to be chief support, he's going to be live on Sky Sports, he's against a young, hungry fighter as well. He's got that real determination. You can see him that every session when he comes in, it's like one step closer to becoming that ultimate fighter.
Drive him up nice and strong.
Yeah, that's better, good. Sink it into your armpits. Good. Yeah, that's it, and then you drive through that sticking point. Excellent stuff, well done. Come on.
Yeah, well, last year we had a world title, WBC, or vacant, and we got it on home soil in Hull. I genuinely believed I was going to beat the kid, but it wanted to be. I got beat by a good lad on the night, and my year sort of went downhill from there. And it just made me realise that it can all just be taken away, and it's took me a full year to come back to like similar position where I was. So like I never took for granted before what I had, but this time round I need to make it count.
Hey, good. Other side. Oh. Head up. Rotate your head as well. There you go.
Gavin McDonnell is a fantastic athlete. You know, he's got bags of grit, bags of determination, you know, and he'll go to the absolute end. You know, he'll do whatever you ask him to do. You know, there's no questions asked. He steps up to everything and completes everything. And from a purely athletic perspective, he is probably one of the most talented from having that engine and having that desire and that aerobic capability that we've had in at Boxing Science. You know, there's very few boxers that can match what he does aerobically. His engine is absolutely fantastic.
So Gavin's king of the ISO holds. He goes to his happy place, stays focused. I think we could leave him here all day, to be fair. Really, the first stages of his strength and conditioning program was just to get him moving better. And because he's been doing that for quite a while without kind of pushing towards like big fights, he's created a really strong foundation. So when he has had to step it up for the big fight, he can go on to like shorter rep ranges, such as 5 reps on the dumbbell chest press, doing deadlifts at well over his body weight now. And the other thing that we've got to consider with that is when we're building the foundations, because we're doing a little bit more reps, this can be a stimulus for hypertrophy. Now he's built them foundations, we can work on shorter rep ranges. So we've been able to take his reps down,
focus on neural adaptations to make sure that it's getting strong and fast, and make sure that it's not being sore and it's going to be fresh for sparring. So we're basically wanting him to be as fit as possible fight night. So his main priority is in this camp isn't necessarily his strength and his speed, it's going to be more his fitness, his sparring fitness.
There you go. It's all about core control. Take your knee too high, you're out of control.
I mean, I've not really been doing too much strength for over years. I mean, we have had guys in, but not consistent. And down there, this really works. And we've got Mayer on board, and just having somebody who knows, do you know what I mean? Just to give you the right foods at the right times is what I needed. He does the numbers and he's worked it all out, and something, do you know what I mean, I'd definitely recommend to a lot of fighters is nail that diet, do you know what I mean, and get somebody to look over it. And I believe I've got the best in Mayers. He's proved it with my twin brother. The conditioning is second to none. And obviously this is my first big fight with you. We've had a couple of little six rounders, but I genuinely believe it'll come into the fight. And if you thought I had stamina before, I genuinely believe it's going to go up to the next level.
He's got that capabilities of like an 800 meter runner, a 1500 meter, and even like a 3K athlete, you know, and upwards, that we'd expect to see on the track. He's definitely got all those capabilities in his locker, which he can then transfer over to the ring, and you know, and that helps his training, it helps his preparation, helps his technical preparation, and everything that goes with it.
Okay, so this is Gav's heart rate monitor. It's linked up to his iPhone, and you can see here that's working in this top zone here, the red zone. So it's 90 to 100% of his maximal heart rate, and this is where basically he's going to be competing at when he's in the boxing ring, when he's in sparring. So it's really important for us that he's getting that conditioning in that red zone, so it's replicating the demands of the sport. Most boxers, they go on to long road runs and they don't even reach this intensity. So Gavin's doing this on 2-3 times a week, and he's getting comfortable in being uncomfortable.
Yeah, so some of his quotes that he's been coming out with is basically, that's another session in the bank, or he's making every session count. And that's really important from a psychological perspective, knowing that the training that he's doing is evidence-based, it's going to be effective, it's going to give him the extra edge when he gets into the ring.
So Gav's just finishing off now. He's hitting 179, 180. On our test, his maximum heart rate is 183. So he's pushing nearly 100% his maximum there. He's looking comfortable, he's looking in control. 3, 2, 1, and that's your lot, Gav. Well done, mate. Good session, that.
Not 1,000,000% do I not believe that I won't win. And I genuinely think I can get a late stoppage just through me wanting it that bit more, how hard I've worked, experience, and the level of the stamina and the fitness what I've got. I'm more than capable of stopping him late on, and I'm very confident.